So let us solve the problem based upon this design of carry calculator. Write down the problem. A water treatment plant is designed to process 50,000 meter cube per day of water. Jar testing indicates that alum dosage of 40 milligram per liter with flocculation at ZT value of 4 into 10 to the power 4 produces optimal results at expected water temperature 15 degree Celsius. Assume Vp is equal to 0.67 meter per second. Then mu is equal to 1.139 into 10 to the power minus 3 Newton second per meter square, and cd is equal to 1.8. Determine first the monthly alum requirement, then flocculation basin having 3 cross flow horizontal paddles are to be used. The flocculator should be a maximum of 12 meter wide, 5 meter deep, in order to connect approximately with settling basin. Next, fourth, the power requirement, and third power requirement, and fourth, the paddle configuration. Is it over?
No, sir. Wait. Over, sir.
Okay. So let us try to solve this problem. First of all, we will find out what is the monthly alum requirement. Okay, so it is given that the discharge of water, it is 50,000 meter cube per day. Okay, then GT value is given, so that we have written 4 into 10 to the power 4. Then VP, it is given 0.67. Mu, that is viscosity, it is given as 1.139 into 10 to the power minus 3 Newton second per meter square. VP is nothing but it is paddle velocity. And CD is equal to 1.8. Depth of tank, it is given 5 meter. Width, 12 meter. Here you can see this, everything is given here. Alum dose is equal to 40 mg per liter. Okay. So after writing these given things, let us find the alum requirement. Alum requirement here, they have given the dose for the alum, that is 40 mg per liter. Okay, so that is the dose they have given in mg per liter. Now, this is the formula to find out the alum requirement. So write down this formula in your notebook. Alum required is equal to Q into alum dose. Right. So this is the discharge. You can say it is in cubic meter per second or per day into alum dose. It is mg per liter. So now here, meter cube per day into mg per liter. If you see at these units, this is the unit of volume. This is the unit of volume. Either convert this in liter or convert this in meter cube. Okay, ya doni peki aplyala ya tikani karava lagel. And after that, this unit will get cancelled, and you will get the unit as mg per day. Then we can convert this mg milligram into gram, and gram into kilogram. Okay, so that you will get the value kg per day, and also you can find out if in one day, if this is the dose, then for 1 month what will be the requirement of the alum. म्हणजे एक पर डे जर तुम्हाला रिक्वायरमेंट निघाली तर एक महिन्यामध्ये किती अलम आपल्याला त्या ठिकाणी लागेल त्या प्लांट वरती हे आपल्याला काढता येईल बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग दिस वैल्यू बाय 30 राइट. सो दिस वे दिस इज द लॉजिक बिहाइंड दिस प्रॉब्लम दिस पर्टिक्युलर वन. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हियर वी विल राइट डाउन द डिस्चार्ज 50,000 क्यूबिक मीटर क्यूब पर डे इनटू एलम डोस इट इज 40 एमजी पर लीटर राइट. नाउ हियर इट इज मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 10 टू द पॉवर 3 देन 10 टू द पॉवर माइनस 6 एंड 30. So this 30 is for converting this in this days into month. Per day chai vich apan yati kan directly month ni apan kaadu shakto. Kiwa yati kan ek step wadwa to avoid the confusion. So instead of you can avoid this multiplying by 30 so that you will get your answer in kg per day. Okay. So for that you have to multiply it by this value. Also here you have multiplied by 10 to the power 3. Why it is multiplied by 10 to the power 3? To convert this meter cube to the liter. Okay, hey, 50,000 ji ahe he kay hota meter cube per day tela mi kay karto 50,000 gunule 10 टू द पॉवर 3 लिटर असं मला लिहिता येईल. बरोबर आहे, 10 टू द पॉवर 3 लिटर पर डे हे झालं क्यू इन टू दिस 40 हे कशामध्ये एमजी पर लिटर. ओके, हे आपण आता स्टेप बाय स्टेपच सोडूया, म्हणजे तुमच्या टू अवॉइड द कन्फ्युजन. हे डायरेक्टली शॉर्टकट या ठिकाणी लिहिलेलं आहे. हे काय केलं आपण आता, हे 40 mg पर लिटर आहे कसं लिहिलं, आणि ह्याचं आपण कन्वर्जन केलं लिटर पर डे मध्ये. आता हे लिटर या ठिकाणी कॅन्सल करून टाका, राईट? सो यू विल गेट हिअर 50,000 इंटू 10^3 इंटू 40 mg पर डे. ओके, दिस इज mg पर, आता हे डे आलं, हे लिटर कॅन्सल झालं. You will get here unit as a mg per day. Now I want to convert this mg in kg. E kg madhe mala convert karaycha aahe. 1 kg is equal to how much gram? It is 10^3 gram, right? Then 1 gram is equal to how much milligram? It is 10^3 milligram. So 1 kg is equal to how much milligram? It is 10^6 milligram. So now 1 milligram is equal to how much kg? He 10^6 ikade ghun ja, you will get 10^-6 kg, right? So to get this unit as a kg, I have to multiply this value. He already ahe the, I have to multiply it by 10^-6, so that I will get the unit here as a kg per day. Okay, so find out this one up to this one. पहिल्यांदा हे फाइंड आउट करा, mg पर डे किती येते फाइंड आउट करा. आणि हे फाइंड आउट केल्यानंतर ह्या व्हॅल्यूला 10^6 ने मल्टीप्लाय करा, -6 ने, सो दॅट यू विल गेट द व्हॅल्यू इन केजी पर डे. आय थिंक यू विल गेट 2000 केजी पर डे, एम आय करेक्ट? एका दिवसामध्ये एवढी अलम त्या ठिकाणी लागेल. Has anyone got this value 2000?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I want to find out what is the alum requirement per month. Eka mahinyamadhye kiti lagel? So I have to multiply this value by 30. So you will get this as a 60,000 kg per month. मुझे एका महिन्यामध्ये 60,000 किलो अलम लागेल. So this is the huge requirement. Because here the quantity of water per day is 50,000 meter cube. Very large quantity. If you convert this in liter, it will be 50 × 10^6 लिटर पर डे. एव्हरी वन शुड डू द कॅल्क्युलेशन पार्ट. सी हाऊ दिस अलम डोस इज कॅल्क्युलेटेड. सो आय हॅव टोल्ड इन द प्रिव्हियस स्लाइड, जी जार टेस्ट आपण करतो, त्या जार टेस्टचा वापर करून आपण तो ऑप्टिमम डोस ऑफ अलम तो आपण फाइंड आउट करतो त्या पर्टिक्युलर पाण्यासाठी. प्रत्येक पाण्याला हा वेगळा डोस असेल. प्रत्येक पाण्याला म्हणजे सोर्स ऑफ वॉटर इज इफ इट इज सेम देन देर इज नॉट नेसेसरी टू चेंज दिस डोस. एकदाच काढून ठेवायचं. बट ड्युरिंग द रेनी सीझन याची टर्बिडिटी वाढू शकते. ॲट दॅट टाइम यू हॅव टू अगेन फाइंड आउट व्हॉट इज द डोस ऑफ द अलम बाय युझिंग जार टेस्ट. हे सगळ्यांना समजलं इथपर्यंत पार्ट?
Yes, sir.
okay. Then next is ZT. We will calculate the ZT value, and then from that you will get the time. The population we're seeing having this dimensions they have given. So let us find out the time here for this. ZT value is given as 4 into 10 to the power 4. Okay. And in the criteria, we have seen that what should be the value of Z, that is velocity gradient, velocity of flow, velocity gradient per second. Yes, Z. So it is in the range of 10 to the power minus 1 to the 75. And ZT factor 10 to the power 4 to 10 to the power 5. So here the value of Z is assumed as 30 per second. Okay. Now let us find out the time required for this processing. You will get the time in second, and then it is converted in minute. Do the calculation part for this. So here let us come back to ZT value here. So what is ZT? So Z is nothing but it is velocity gradient, and what is T? It is the displacement time. T is equal to volume upon Q. Displacement time कसा काढला या किंवा डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइमचा वापर करून आपण या ठिकाणी या दोन्हीपैकी एक व्हॅल्यू फाइंड आउट करू शकतो. वी नो दॅट डिस्चार्ज इज इक्वल टू व्हॉल्यूम अपॉन टाइम. सो टाइम इज इक्वल टू हे टी इकडे घ्या, हे क्यू इकडे घ्या, व्हॉल्यूम अपॉन डिस्चार्ज. सो दिस इज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइम टी. सो हियर वी फाउंड दिस डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइम टी. This is the ZT value. Okay. Yes. Now come here back. So we got this T is equal to, has everyone got this value? 22.22 minutes. Now from that formula, whatever the formula we have seen there, T is equal to volume divided by discharge. Now here if you multiply here, take this Q here, you will get the volume of tank. Volume is equal to time into discharge. So multiply, volume is 50,000 meter cube per day. So now this is the minute. To convert this minute in hour, we have to multiply it by 60, and to convert that hour in day, we have to multiply it by 24. So this is the conversion of minutes into the hour, minutes into the day. So the volume you got here as a 771.52 meter cube. Are you getting my point? Discharge into time. Time is 22.22 minute. So here the volume is equal to we have to divide it value, this value by this value. This is in minute. Minute hour madhe conversion karayche aplyala. So kay karla gel, we have to divide this by 60. Apan ya tikani multiply lile, divided by 60, then divided by 24. Do that and tell me whether you are getting the same answer or not.
Yes, sir.
Here it is by mistake, it is written as a multiply. It should be divided by. Okay, you will get this volume in meter cube. Next, next thing about the finding the volume of each compartment. Okay, how to find out the volume of each compartment? So here let us see what is given in the problem. How much compartments are asked here? The flocculation basin having 3 cross flow horizontal paddles are to be used. Okay, 3 paddles use karayche ahet manje 3 compartments aplyala ya tikani karav lagtil. So we have to divide that total volume by 3 to get the volume of each compartment. Okay, हे जे या ठिकाणी तुम्हाला दिसत आहेत डायग्राम मध्ये, असे 3 कंपार्टमेंट आहेत, 1 2 3, असे 3 कंपार्टमेंट. तर प्रत्येक कंपार्टमेंटचं व्हॉल्यूम किती असेल? सो दॅट वी हॅव टू फाइंड आउट. सो डिवाइड दॅट टोटल व्हॉल्यूम, हे खाली जे व्हॉल्यूम आपल्याला आलेलं आहे त्याला काय करायचं, 3 डिवाइड करायचं आहे. सो यू विल गेट द व्हॉल्यूम ऑफ इच कंपार्टमेंट. सो वी गेट द व्हॅल्यू हियर 257.15 मीटर क्यूब. Next, do the calculation, write down this value. Now here you can see the depth is here asked that consider the depth as a 5 meter. It is given here. So for the equal distribution of velocity gradient, velocity gradient's equal distribution throughout that cross section area honesty, the cross section area of the compartment, it should be square in shape. Now the depth of tank, it is 5 meter. So if we have to divide this width, total width of the tank in 3 compartments, so the total width of the tank total width kiti adilla apilla 15 meter. Oh, it is guess given that 12 meter should be the wide maximum. So here we consider it as a 15 meter wide. Okay, and we divide this in 3 compartments, so the each width will be 5 meter. So this 5 meter and this 5 meter, now it becomes square in shape, right? So for have equal distribution of the velocity gradient, cross section area of the each compartment should be square. Okay, so depth is equal to 1/3 of the length. So assuming depth 5, then length will be equal to 15 meter. So this is about length. We are talking here about the length. So now total width is equal to W is equal to volume upon depth into length equal to. So how it has come? How it will come? I will tell you. So volume is nothing but
length into depth into height.
Correct. This is the length. This is h, lbh, and this is you can say b. So width is equal to kailma. If v is equal to lbh, then v is equal to volume upon l into h. Okay, so the same is given. Width is equal to volume divided by depth h into l. So putting that values here, 771.52 is the volume that we have what here, total volume divided by this 5 is the depth and 15 meter is the length. And here we got width as a 10.28. So the here in the diagram, this 15 meter is the length. He width nahi hai. He kya hai? He length hai. This is the depth. And yacha jo width hai, he width aplyala ya side la disel. Yashin. Okay. This will be the width. This is the length. And if any condition ka dile, width should not be exceed 12 meter. 12 meter pekshe jast nasala pahije. Hi aplyala kadayche. He kadnyasathi apan agodar hi kay kele 5 meter tyane dilile ki apan assume kele 5 meter depth. Ani mag total length je ahe 15 meter apan tya thikani ahe keli consider keli. Okay. Mag total volume je ahe आता ह्याला कंपार्ट तीन कंपार्टमेंटमध्ये आपण काय केलं, डिवाइड केलं तीन याच्यामध्ये. सो दॅट इच कंपार्टमेंट विल बी ऑफ स्क्वेअर शेप. पाच पाच मीटरचे असे तीन कंपार्टमेंट आपण या ठिकाणी कन्सिडर केले. आता आपल्याला टोटल व्हॉल्यूम माहीत आहे, टोटल डेप्थ माहीत आहे, टोटल लेंथ माहीत आहे. कॅन वी फाईंड आउट व्हॉट इज द टोटल विड्थ हिअर? सो त्याचा वापर करून त्या ठिकाणी विड्थ फाईंड आउट केलेली. ओके, so here they have found the width and it has come 10.28 or nearly 10.3 meter. Okay, so these are the dimensions of that compartment. Now out of that 10.3 meter, here you can see in the section how it is divided. Total is 10.3 meter. So here the 0.4 meter has kept here side. Ya tikani 0.4 thevle. Don blade madla antar je ahe, it is 1 meter, here 1 meter, and hg width ahe, it is 2.5 meter, it is total length of the blade. In this way the dimensions have to be kept. Total depth ahe 5 meter ani ya tikani varti space sodla 0.4 meter, khali 0.4 meter sodlela ahe. फ्लोअर आणि वरता ह्याच्यामध्ये, आणि ह्याची जी टोटल हाईट घेतली आहे इट इज 4.2 मीटर. असे आपल्याला या ठिकाणी त्या डायमेन्शनचा वापर करून डायग्राम त्या ठिकाणी काढावं लागतं. देन अज्युम टेपर्ड जी व्हॅल्यू ॲज फॉलोज. Z1, Z2, Z3 अशा तीन व्हॅल्यू या ठिकाणी कन्सिडर केलेले आहेत. अँड देन इट हॅज बीन फाउंड द पॉवर रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर द each compartment P1, P2, P3. Okay, and here let us find out the value of power. Ha formula apan varti lihilela ahe. G is equal to under root of, this is the velocity gradient, P upon mu into V. Okay, so putting these values here in this formula, P is equal to kailya, the squaring karaj both side, do the squaring on both side, you will get the g square is equal to p upon mu into v. Then p is equal to g square into v into mu, Okay, P1 is equal to, now put that for the compartment number 1, put Z1 is equal to 40, Z is equal to 40. Then for the compartment number 2, put Z is equal to 30. And for the 3, put Z is equal to 20. Okay, and find out what is the values of P1, P2, P3. And these values we will get in kilowatt. Okay. And after that, getting that power, then paddle configuration part comes. For the first compartment, this velocity ratio VR is equal to 0.75 VP, that is velocity of paddle. Okay, so velocity of paddle, they have given. Take that value there. Okay, then find out VR, then area of paddle is equal to LV into W into N. So this we have written there previously. So put that values here. N is nothing but number of paddles. Eka compartment madhe kiti paddle hai? 3 hai. Okay, so multiply it. We will get here this value, AP. Now P1 is equal to CD into mu into AP into VR upon 2. So this formula, have you written this formula somewhere? This formula I think we have not written, so it is directly here. So you have to write down this formula also. And the time is about to finish, let us do it completely. And you will get this value, W is equal to 0.137 meter. This is the width of this paddle, okay, this width W. It has come as a 0.1357 meter. Then we have to find out omega, that is revolution per minute, angular velocity. By using this formula, Vp is equal to pi into d into w. You will get, putting this value, you will get this angular velocity. Similarly, for the second compartment, we have to find out the Vr, that is velocity ratio. Then Vp, you will get. And from that omega, that is what will be the angular velocity of that pedal, you will get here. Similarly for the third compartment, we should find what is the velocity ratio, then what should be the width of the blade, and then angular velocity omega is equal to 1.07, you will get here. And this is